In this episode of our van conversion series, we are building the beds for our camper van. We have a double bed and a single bed for our daughter. Under the double bed, we have our garage plant where we store our mountain bikes inside the van. The mountain bike storage also determines the height of the bed and where we put the dividing wall between the garage and the living area. If you want to know more about our design, you can check out our design video I will link in the description. So let's take a look at the specific design of the bed we made in SketchUp. We made this design before we even bought the van, so without knowing the specific way or possibilities to build the beds. We guessed we'd get there when the time came, and we did. The height above our bed is very specific, because it has to be just above the mountain bikes to be able to store them without a problem, but also we want to have as much height above the bed to make the bed spacious enough to use as part of the living area. For instance, it has to be able to be used for a movie night with at least 4 to 5 people. In the whole design process, reducing the weight of the build was constantly on our mind. So we tried to use as little materials and as many lightweight materials as possible. 2 large beams along the walls and 6 cross beams from side to side should be strong enough to hold our bed. Especially because 2 of these cross beams will be supported by the dividing wall that separates the garage from the living space. Most important was how to build the support structure of our bed on the sides. After contemplating several methods, we eventually decided to use the factory-made holes in the sides of the cargo bay to attach the vertical battens to. This sounds easy, but it's not. We wanted the bolts to be on the inside of the cargo bay so we wouldn't have the sharp edges of the bolts sticking out, which would have been much easier installing, by the way. So we took the hard way and we had to find a way to get the nuts onto the bolts from behind the metal ribs of the walls. We had to remove some of the insulation we had just put in to make room. A trick we used was putting on paint on the end of a bolt. Put the bolt in place through the factory-made holes. Put the batten in the exact location and push the batten into the paint at the end of the bolt. It leaves a mark where you have to drill a hole. And you have to do this for 10 battens, each with 2 holes to drill. All in all, putting the battens in was a time-consuming job as well. And this is definitely a 2-person job. I've tried to do this alone, but I failed miserably. There is hardly any room to work in these very tight spaces. It took us forever to get every nut and bolt secured, and we had to use every trick in the book. We duct taped nuts on wrenches and used magnets on sticks to get the nuts into position on the inside of the metal ribs. And every time a nut fell out, we had to find it. Again and again. Often using magnets on a string. And you need to. You can't leave a loose bolt rattling around in your van or causing rust. Profane language was used repeatedly during this process. We are only showing you the harmonious times of this phase of the bed build. After all battens were in place, we double-checked the exact height of each batten to make sure we would have a leveled bed. Where needed, we used a handsaw to cut some of the battens to size, but these were just little bits. So we basically got the measuring right. After placing the battens, we did the vapor barrier for the insulation on the walls. We had to work around the vertical beams to keep these visible. If you want to know more about how we insulated the van, we have another video for that. I will link this video in the description. On both sides of the bed, we attached a horizontal beam to the vertical battens. These will support the beams that we will put from side to side. As these will carry all the weight, these beams need to be attached to the battens very securely. To secure the horizontal beams to the vertical battens, we used wood screws size M8 with hex heads. For extra strength, we used wood glue on each contact point. Of course, we pre-drilled holes in these beams as not to split the wood when putting in these huge screws. These are the 5 battens and a horizontal beam on top, finished, on each side of the van. On the left, between the battens, you see an opening. This is the location of our electrical panel in the garage. As you can see, we designed the height of the bed to be able to exactly fit a bike slide loaded with a mountain bike. Now we are going to take a look at building our daughter's bed on the side that doubles as a bench in the living area. Here you can see how well our floor design worked out. In our design, we placed the floor battens in the exact location we had to attach our interior to the floor. So we would have sturdy battens to secure this to and not only the 12mm plywood on the floor. So we were able to secure the battens and beams of our daughter's bed right into the floor battens, just as we intended in our design. And as you can see, we used our pocket hole jig on almost every batten and beam. We bought a relatively cheap one to test and we ended up using it intensively during the whole van build. And as you have seen throughout this video, we are using a carpenter square to make sure the battens and beams are lined up correctly. Using a spirit level, for instance, isn't a good idea because the van is never really leveled, especially when you are standing in it. So always use a carpenter square. As far as our daughter's bed goes, from a construction standpoint, it isn't a very complex structure to build. The bed is under the double bed for about half the length. Where this bed ends, the dividing wall between the garage and living area starts. Under this bed, we will be building 2 large drawers for storage. We planned our daughter's bed to use a slatted frame having a standard size of 70cm by 200cm. So that's the basic form of our daughter's bed done. Now we are placing the first wooden beams from side to side. The one in the back is in line with the dividing wall at the end of our daughter's bed. The other one is approximately in the middle of the double bed, so it has an extra support function. Also, these two beams hold apart the horizontal beams on the side, so they can't move inwards. These two beams in the middle section of the bed we doubled by a second beam on top, to give it double the strength to make the bed as strong as possible. One of the beams turned out to be a little bit warped, so when installing this one we had to use adhesive and clamps to force it to be straight and keep it tightly together while the glue hardened. On the whole length of the beam, we used huge screws to secure it. And eventually, this beam came out pretty straight. So, now might be a good time to talk about the weight we designed the bed to be able to hold. We assumed we needed to support about 200 kilograms, and 400 kilograms in a worst case scenario. Or a best case scenario, however you want to look at it. We have 6 crossbeams that are dividing this weight over 12 points on both sides of the beams along the walls. So 200 kilograms divided by 12 is about 17 kilograms per point, or 34 kilograms at most. This weight is distributed via the 10 vertical battens on both sides, plus the beams in the middle are supported by the dividing wall that is distributing a large part of the weight to the floor along the length of this wall. This should be more than strong. For the remaining sections of the bed, we made double crossbeams with leftover bits in the middle to give them more strength. On both ends of these crossbeams, we put leftover pieces of the battens that have a large surface to secure the crossbeams to the beams along the walls. These made it possible to secure the crossbeams to the side beams with large screws working from above. For the front and the back of the bed, we had to make 2 specialized crossbeams, in which we integrated the plywood sheets to cover the front and the back of the bed. For each, we had to come up with a custom design, with an integrated cover and extra battens for optimal strength. Especially the front beam we wanted to make extra strong, because these will have to carry our full weight each time we get in and out of bed. So this became an impressive and complex structure. We wanted to keep the front sheet clean, so we put all the screws in from the back of the structure. First, we glued the support batten to the back of the front sheet using wood glue to give it extra strength. Then we secured it with small screws working from the back. Of course, it's essential to choose the right length of these screws. Next, we attach a strengthened crossbeam to the strengthened front sheet, so in theory, the result should be a front structure with more than double the strength of a normal one. As you can see here, the front beam is a massive structure of wood that turned out to be more than strong enough to support the weight going in and out of the bed. With all the beams in place, we've created a sturdy flat surface to place the 2 slatted frames on, that will form our king-size double bed. This construction actually turned out to be much stronger than we initially designed and thought possible. Better safe than sorry. Also, the construction was relatively lightweight. One of the advantages of this design is the open structure under the mattresses. First, because we use regular slatted frames, and second, because under these slatted frames the air can flow freely under the bed, so minimizing the chances of mold to grow. With the bed in place, our design turned out to be exactly what we aimed for, and we had definitely chosen the right height of our camper van. The Mercedes Sprinter L483, the high top, leaves that very welcome extra space of about 15 to 20 centimeters extra above your head while frolicking around in the bed. Which makes the bed an added living space you can lounge and sit in, as opposed to a small, low ceiling space that you can only sleep in. All in all, we are very happy with the results, and we have a spacious bed with enough headspace for a great variety of leisurely activities. I hope the detailed look at the construction of our double bed has given you some useful insights and ideas for your own campervan conversion. So thanks for watching, please subscribe to our channel, and we will see you on the next one.